हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड टेंसेस विथ यू ऑल. देयर आई कंप्लीटेड टू टॉपिक्स, द प्रेजेंट एंड द पास्ट, बट द थर्ड वन इज स्टिल येट टू बी डन एंड आई विल बी कवरिंग अप दैट टॉपिक इन दिस वीडियो. टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग फ्यूचर टेंस इन डिटेल. एंड what do you understand by the term future? Future is what is going to happen in the coming time. So basically that is what future means. Even here we are going to see the different situations. Subject, the sentence structure of a future tense sentence is subject plus will plus shall, will or shall plus verb in the first form plus object. The simple future tense is used for an action that will take place at a particular time in the future. Okay, this is a action which will take place at any particular time in the future, which has not happened or is happening just now. Simple future tense also expresses an action that takes place at some time in future. Like for example, if I say we will go to Delhi tomorrow. This tense is also used to denote the opinion of the speaker. In this tense also comes the opinion of the speaker. I believe that he will certainly succeed in the examination. Okay, so this is the example for denoting opinion. In the future tense, we use shall and will to denote the future time. Okay. And will is used with the first person, that is I, and we denote I and we, and to denote determination and willingness, will is used. Okay. And shall is used with the first person to denote an offer. So when you are offering, you use shall. Let's move on to the sentence structure. Subject of an affirmative, sentence structure of an affirmative future tense sentence. Okay, so it goes like subject plus shall, will plus verb in the first form plus other words. Okay, so we use shall with I and we all just stick this in your mind that we will always use shall with I and we and will with you, he, she and they. So to avoid this confusion, just stick that in your mind. Okay, for example, Ravi will play in the park. So here Ravi is the subject, we have used will with Ravi, play is the first form of the verb, and in the park are the other words. One more example, if I give you, he will go to America next month. Okay, so even this can be the example. Moving on to the negative sentence. In the negative sentence, we add not after will and shall. Okay, here to make it negative, we will add not after will and shall. Like if you go and see this sentence structure, it goes like subject shall will plus not plus verb in the first form plus other words. So if you relate it with the example Ravi, again the subject, we have used will with Ravi, and not shows the negation in this sentence, and play is the first form of the verb in the park. Other words. So this makes it the negative, simple negative sentence. Now we move on to interrogative sentence. Again here in the interrogative sentence, shall and will come before the subject. Okay, so we use shall and will before the subject and first form of the verb after the subject. Like for example, if you see, will Ravi play in the park? Will is the word which we are going to use before the subject. Ravi is the subject here and play is the first form of the verb, so that makes it interrogative. Like if I give you one with shall I attend the meeting on Monday? So this also becomes a interrogative sentence. I have made with shall, so we use shall with I and we only. Okay, now moving on to interrogative negative sentence. Interrogative negative, you have to make it, and most important, if it is interrogative then you have to put question mark whether it is positive or negative. Interrogative negative sentence. In it, we use shall or will before the subject and not after the subject. Okay. We use shall and will before the subject and not after the subject to make it interrogative negative. Like, for example, will Ravi not play in the park? So, shall, will, mein se we have used will with Ravi. Again, the subject. Not shows negation. Play is the first form of the verb. And in the park, other word plus question mark. Like, for example, if I give you another one with shall. Shall I not attend the meeting on Monday? So, this is the sentence which I showed you all with shall. Moving on to the next, future continuous tense. Okay, future continuous tense is used to express an action which will be in progress at the particular time in the future. Matlab, it will be going on in future. Going on at some time in the future. Like, for example, the teacher shall be teaching this lesson. If I give you another example, he will be living with us next month. Matlab, somewhere in the future these actions are going to take place. Now let's see the sentence structures. Affirmative sentence, we use shall be, will be according to the subject followed by first form of the verb plus ing. ing to the verb plus other words. So, I, subject, shall, will, mein se we have used will be playing cricket tomorrow. Moving on to the negative sentence, subject, shall, will plus not. Plus be, plus verb in the first form, plus ing to the verb, plus other words. I will not be playing cricket tomorrow. So, I is again the subject, we have used will not be playing cricket tomorrow. Other words, playing is the verb with ing. So, this makes it negative. Interrogative negative. Shall, will, plus subject, plus be, plus verb in the first form, plus ing, plus other words. So, if you ask a question, you will say, shall I be playing cricket tomorrow? So, shall, we have used with I plus be, plus play with ing form of the verb, cricket and tomorrow and question mark most important. Interrogative negative, shall, will plus subject plus not plus be plus verb in the first form plus ing plus other words. So shall with I, not shows the negation, be playing cricket tomorrow. Same, but you just add not to it. Moving on to future perfect tense. Future perfect tense is used to indicate the completion of an action by a certain period of time in the future. It denotes an action that will be completed in the future. Like, for example, if I give you, you will have finished your project by next year. I shall have reached Delhi by December. Okay, so if you see the sentence structure over here for the future perfect tense, affirmative sentence, subject plus shall, will plus have plus verb in the third form plus other words. So, shall, will, she will have completed the work by then. She is the subject. We have used will with she. Have completed is the third form of the verb and other words. Now we'll move on to the negative sentence. Same sentence structure, but you just have to put not in between shall, will or shall, will and. So, she will not have completed the work by then. She, again the subject, will, you added not for the negative thing, and then completed the homework. Verb will also remain in the third form and other words will follow. Interrogative sentence. Okay, now moving on to interrogative sentence. Again, shall, will plus subject plus have plus verb in the third form plus other words plus question mark. Interrogative, so question mark is very important. Will she have completed the work by then? So, will, with will, the subject is she, have, verb is the completed is the third form of the verb, the work by then, question mark. So this makes it into an interrogative sentence. We use shall or will before the subject and have after the subject. Interrogative negative sentence. We use shall and will before the subject and not have after it. Okay. So, will she not have completed the work by then? Will she is the subject, not have completed is the third form, or the work by then, other words, question mark. So this is the sentence structure. These are the sentence structure for the future perfect tense. Now we'll be looking into future perfect continuous tense. The future tense, a perfect the future perfect continuous tense expresses an action continuing beyond the given time in the future. Okay, so this shows the action which is beyond the future time in the future. Now see the sentence structure for affirmative sentence. Subject plus shall, will plus have plus been plus verb in the first form plus ing plus other words. So Raj will have been playing. Raj is the subject. Will have been playing. Will is the we have used will with Raj. Have been we have used, and verb with the ing form, so playing. Similarly, to make it negative, Raj will not have been playing. So we will add not in between will, shall and have. So that will make the sentence negative. Interrogative sentence, again, will or shall will come first, plus subject plus have been plus verb in the first form plus ing to it plus other words and question mark. So here will, Raj is the subject, we have used will with Raj, have been playing, the ing form of the verb. And similarly, just to make this here you have to remember that will comes first and subject comes, will or shall comes first and subject comes later. In interrogative negative sentence, shall, will plus subject plus not plus have plus been plus will plus ing plus other words to plus question mark. So will Raj not have been playing? We use shall, will before the subject and not have been after the subject. So see this, will Raj not have been playing? We have used Raj is the subject, will before, and not have been after the subject. So I hope this is clear with you all. I have finished with the chapter tenses. In case if you have any queries, you all can contact me. I'll also be sending you all some extra exercise in your next session. Any queries, please contact me. Thank you.